Arrowhead. There is a team, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 10. 10 teams are there. Now, opportunity for error, I'm going to ask you to test for crack, count, shape, color, and taste. First, what you do is, first of all, find out the counts are okay. The gems packet, it will be written as 12 numbers. See whether there are 12 numbers. See whether there are 12 numbers there. If there are 13 numbers, then the error is 1. If there are 11 numbers, also there is 1. Now, if there are 10 numbers, counts are 10. And if there are 11 numbers, error is 1. If there are 9 numbers, then also error is 1. Okay. But please tell me what is the count and then error. Crack, how many gems are there with cracks? How many gems are not as per that cylindrical shape? How many gems are all faded color? The colors may be different. That is okay. But the color should not be faded color. If there is a faded color, you say that how many of them are faded color. So now you know how to give me the data. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And finally, the fifth data is fifth opportunity for error is taste. Now you taste it. If it is okay, all are good. If it is not okay, all are bad. Error is all the 10. So the packets are gem packets. I've got items per box is 10. Number of boxes so far I've taken is only 1. And then OFE, opportunity for error is 5. Do you know how you got it? Opportunity for error is equal to 5. It is here, no? See my arrow.
Yes.
Do you see this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Opportunity
see.
For error. I've written here. I've written it as 5 here. Do you know how I got it 5?
Yes, sir.
Tell me how I got it. The
ND,
crack, ND, count, ND, shape, color, and taste are the defects. Okay. These are the 5 counts. Therefore, for each gem, there are 5 opportunities for my finding out an error. Similarly, what happens now in the examination, in the green belt examination, you will certainly get this question 90%. The computer will be there. I will be inspecting computer. I'll be inspecting computer for motherboard, keyboard, and monitor. And I'm counting 200 laptops I'm inspecting. Can you tell me what is the opportunity for error?
3,
that's all. I'm going to include one more thing, hard disk. Then opportunity for error is 4. So you should know opportunity for error. What is it? Here it is 5. And then defects, you are going to tell me, I'm going to mark it. Now tell me, Mahesh, are you having? How many defects are there? Count, is that, are there 10 are there?
Sir, I don't
understand. You can take my Viru.
Whoever is having, tell me.
Viru, I have a packet.
Yeah.
So the count is 10. No problem, sir.
No problem. No error. 0. Then color.
No. My name is there. Now you can directly put on my name.
What is your name?
Viru.
Viru, huh?
Yeah.
Viru, okay. 0.
Count then. Is correct.
Okay.
Crack is, color is 1 is fading.
1 is defective. Right. Then?
Crack is also 1 crack.
1. Very good.
Shape is fine, sir. 0.
0.
Shape.
Then taste is also 0. Okay. Yeah. Anybody else?
There is Sandeep.
There is?
Sandeep, sir.
Sandeep, tell me.
Yes, sir. So count is 0.
Count is 0.
Color is 1. One
color is 1. There.
Crack is 1. For shape, it is 4.
Shape is 4. Defects. And this is 0.
Yes.
Please note, what I will do is, I'll make this as 0 is first. Control X. I'll put it as Control V. And then Santip also, I'll put Control X. Control V. Right. And then I will make this change. Control X. Control V. And then Control X. Control V. Okay. So,
Gaurav, sir.
Huh?
Gaurav, sir.
One second. Gaurav, tell me. Yeah.
So count is 10.
Count is 10 is okay. No, right.
And cracks 4.
Crack is 4. Okay.
Color 9 disc. Sir, 9 discolor.
9 is discolored. Then
shape, sir, all okay.
Shape is all okay and taste is also okay. Anybody else? Tell me your name. Yeah.
Hello, we can add Neil Anshal.
Huh?
You can add it, Neil Anshal.
Spelling?
I have Neil Anshal.
Spelling?
Neil Anshal, N-I.
Yeah, while talking, if you come on video.
Neil Anshal, okay. Yeah. Right, tell me. Count?
Count is okay, sir. 0.
Right, color?
Color also okay.
Okay, then crack?
Crack is 4.
4.
Defect is 1.
Shape is 1. And taste will be 0.
Taste will be 0.
Okay.
So this is Giridharan. And
yes?
This is Giridharan. And
Giridharan. Okay.
Count is 0.
0.
Defect is 4.
Defect is 4 color.
Yes, sir. And crack is 6.
Crack is 6.
Shape is perfect, it's 0.
0. And taste is 0. Okay, almost. Yes. Then anybody else? Please note here. See here. How many packets I opened? 5 packets. Niranjan, Giridhar, Sandeep, Biru, and Gaurav. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
5 packets means 5 into 10, 50 samples are there. The sample is 50. Can you see here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And then YFE is 5, I already explained you. Defects are 36 so far. Because count is 0, color was 15, crack was 16, shape was 5. Adding up, it is 36. Or by name, Niranjan has given 5 defects. Giridhar has given 10 defects. Sandeep has given 6. And Viru 2 and Gaurav 13. Total is 36. So defects are 36. Now please see here, number of boxes into X items per box is what is sample. That is 10 into 5. YFE is 5. Defects per opportunity is defects per 36 by total opportunity for error is sample size, sample into number of sample into opportunity per sample. That is 50 into 5 is 250. So 36 by 250 is what is defects per opportunity. You got it? The formula is given here. Answer is given here. You can do it manually and cross check it with the computer. This template is given to you. Okay?
Okay.
Clear?
Okay, sir.
Now, DPMO is, I am multiplying DPO by 1 million. That's all. Multiplying by 1 million, you will get DPMO. And sigma level is a function of DPMO. I will give you the formula. You can also refer the table or the graph. Whatever you do it, you will get the same answer. Sigma level short term and sigma level long term. 2.56 is the short term sigma level. Always the difference will be 1.5. So we find the sigma level short term and then subtracting 1.5 and get this long term. Okay. So this is how you find out the sigma level. Sigma level gives you the performance of your project, of your GEMS packet now being produced. Clear?
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Now, yes, sir. The question arises is, what should be the sigma level? What is the name of the topic of the name of the course? Sigma.
Sigma.
Now, what should you get for a perfect project? Process? Six sigma. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Now, we are having a six sigma level of short-term sigma level of 2.56. Is it a good project or bad project?
Bad.
Bad. Nobody is buying. That is market. There is no market. But is there no market there for GEMS?
No. Market. Market is there, sir.
Market is there. They are doing very well. Fantastic. Monopoly. Almost. No. Then what is the mistake that we have made?
Sample.
But please note, when you are playing with the template, put it in the order. Don't leave gap and all. So I left gap because I know it, how to use it. That's why I'm clear. Otherwise, you play with no gap. Then only you will be able to get the correct answers. Yeah, tell me, sir.
What is CTQ. CTQ.
CTQ.
CTQ. CTQ.
Yeah. What is, very good. What is CTQ. The CTQ here now? CTQ, this is not the corrective measures. We are not supposed to ask count, color, crack and all. Children are not at all bothered about it. They are bothered only about taste. Then in that case, you have given like a child, no defect. That means it is perfectly doing well. Clear?
Yes, sir.
CTQ is very important. There is one more defect also. Can anyone tell me?
If you consider only taste as the defect, sigma level will be more than 6. That is why they are now monopoly.
Now, participants, there is one more defect I have made. What is that? Can anyone tell me? Yesterday, I have responded also like this one. Somebody was telling that they have inquired in the market and then he has made something, but nothing was sold. And then he was making a complaint. Then I answered him. What was that? Do you remember?
Customer
should not enter. Yes, I have taken the wrong customers. I should not have taken you at all first. Fine. I should have taken children, your children, all your children I should have taken and then I would have bought 6 sigma. Okay.
Sir, day 2, they have to attend with the children.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll stop sharing. Now you can taste it.
Yeah. Is that all of you understand how to calculate DPMO, first of all?
Yes, sir.
Opportunities for error. Will you be able to calculate any product you are studying? You are interested in calculating the DPMO. Will you be able to identify the opportunities for error?
Yes, sir.
Very good. And then what you need to do is you need to calculate defects per opportunity. Defects per opportunity. Let me tell you, the opportunities for error is 5. You are testing 20 products and every product can have 5 defect. Now, what is the total opportunity for error? A product can have maximum of 5 defects. That means you have a 5-point check. You are checking every product at 5 different aspects. And now you are inspecting 20 products. What is the total number of opportunities for error?
20 into 5.
That's all. 20 into 5, 100. If there are 100 opportunities, after completing your inspection of all 20 items, you identify 50 defects. Now, what is the defect per opportunity here? Total opportunity for error is, you said 100, and actually identified defect is 50. So, defect per opportunity is defect divided by total number of opportunity. So, tell me, what is DPO now? Defect per opportunity? 50. By 100. What is 50 by 100? 1 by 2. What is 1 by 2? 0.5. If 0.5 is your defect per opportunity, what will be your defect per million opportunity? 0.5
into 100 million.
10 power 6. 0.5 into 10 power 6. What is 0.5 into 10 power 6? How much it is? 1 into 1 million is 1 million. Half into 1 million is? 5 lakhs. So, isn't it? So, your DPMO is that much. 5 lakhs defects per million opportunities. So, that is what has been, automated with your Excel template. And it will work well for 5 opportunities. You can make it for 6, you can make it for 7, or you can make it for anything. But if you are thorough with the concept, then you can easily calculate the DPMO for any product. And once DPMO is known, sigma level can be known. And that is also connected with the Excel formula, because there is a relationship. 6 sigma level, how many defects will be there? It is 3.4. 6 sigma level, the defect is 3.4. Same way for any DPMO, you can calculate the sigma level also. So that is what the template is doing it for you. I think you have understood clearly the DPMO calculation. Sir, shall we move on to the next, or you want me to teach the graphs?
Sir,